Today we're going to take a look at the ability to do static scans as well as open source scans inside of Fortify on demand. So we're going to go ahead and create a new application. And we can name it whatever we like. We can just call this one open source test. And click next. I'm going to choose a release name. I can just call this one test1. And this is going to be production. And we can click next. We can make this part of finance. And this is part of America's. We can just say investment services. These are must fixes. And then we can click next. Can click next here, and now we can see all the different features of our application. So we'll click save. So now we have a new scan that we can start off here. So I go ahead and click start. I'm going to select static for static scanning, and I'm going to go ahead and choose my assessment. So I'm going to do a static assessment. And then I'm going to select my entitlement. So I'm going to do a subscription for this, that way I can continue to scan it. I'm going to do a manual upload of the code, and I'm going to have a JavaScript app. And I want to include open source. So here, this really provides the ability to perform a sonotype scan along with your typical static scan inside of Fortify on demand. So once I click this, what's going to happen is there'll be both a static scan and a open source scan performed as a part of, you know, the one singular effort. And I'm going to go ahead and click an automated audit preference. And now I can go ahead and start my scan, upload my code. So now I can click next, and I'm going to start my scan. And now it's going to do a scan of both static and open source at the same time. So as this completes, right now it's just uploading the payload into the Fortify on demand system. All right, so now that our code is uploaded, the scan is going to start. Right now it's in the queued state. So while we're waiting on that, I'm going to go ahead and just show you one that I've already completed. So if I go back out to my applications and I search for my sample application that I've started, I can see here that I have 3 criticals, 74 high, 17 medium issues, and 1 low. So with Fortify on Demand and our new abilities to add in open source, we've kind of taken a holistic approach around code analysis, combining both source code and open source analysis into a single dashboard here. We've also added additional language coverage for open source as well, where before it was just Java, now it's also .NET, JavaScript, and Python. And the data is also now, you know, a first-class citizen being integrated into the overall reporting and dashboards in the regular Fortify on demand system. So if I go ahead and click into the application here, again, I can kind of see where I'm at. This is a production application, and I can even click into that further and see individual issues. So if I go up here and I click on my issues, I can see here now the open source information is integrated right along my typical SAST, DAST, and even mobile applications as well, if I wanted to do that. So for instance, I can see here that what the vulnerability is, the component name and where it's at, component version, repository, the actual file locations on where the issue is located. And then I can see the underlying issues and what that may contain. There's also some recommendations here provided that provides me helpful links to be able to go out and do further research on the issues found and what they mean. In addition to that, I also have the ability to have a integrated workflow for open source as well as static scan. So I can go here and I can assign things to a developer. I can give a status to the issue. I can mark it closed, open. So if I wanted to mark it in remediation and I wanted to say it's not an issue because I trust this particular vulnerability that was found. I can go ahead and just mark that low and then add it to the list. And now that issue would be marked a low. So I have a complete ability to audit my issues and remediate them right inside a singular workflow for both static and open source. So we do provide about 70% more vulnerability coverage than alternative open source databases. Through our partnership with Sonatype, we're able to offer that. We're also able to offer a 10 times faster scanning than the National Vulnerability Database. We also examined the fingerprints of 65 million components. So we're not just looking at file names and package manifest, but we're taking a holistic approach to that and kind of looking across the application, both again at the source code and open source components. So now I'm going to go back over here to the application itself and take a look at some of the open source components and what issues we found. So you can see here that you have a complete breakdown on the bill of materials and what, you know, what the component is, the version, the type, and then even the license that goes along with it as well. So you can see here that this is a part of Apache Framework. It's version 2.1. And here's the particular license to go along with it. So if I go back out to my my issues here, and if I wanted to take a kind of a deeper look into the release itself, go back and search my sample application, I can see I can go into my releases, and I can search for Sonatype, which is my sample. So if I go here and I look at my components again, now I can break it down by releases. So as you saw before, I can still see that complete bill of materials, version number, type, critical issues that are being shown with it, and the additional licenses as well. But I can also drill into the releases, and I can see where the issues are actually coming from a higher level. So if I'm, you know, reviewing an entire application portfolio, this gives me the ability to go in here and say, okay, these particular applications have these issues with critical highs right now. Maybe I need to address those ones first. So in addition to providing it inside of the UI and providing all this great information around dashboards and feature functionality and giving you the ability to both do static and open source scanning in one easy application, we also provide that inside of an API as well. So if I go out to the API Explorer, and in addition to all of our additional APIs, I can go here and get open source, and I can get all the same information that's provided on the UI as a part of the API. So if I wanted to program it in and get that information back in an automated method, I could still do that. So I can still get all the important component information, version licenses, all the information that we saw in the UI, we can also get through in a programmatic way through the API. So that provides the ability to automate these practices and be able to have developers pull it right into their workflow rather than having the UI. That's it for today. We have the ability to, again, do open source and static scanning all in one complete, easy-to-use package as a part of Fortify On Demand in our partnership with Sonatype. Thank you.